In my opinion, a lithophane is one of the neatest things that you can print on a 3D printer. I ran across these a few weeks ago and I was really amazed at how clear the image is when it comes off the printer. When you look at the actual print for the Mona Lisa, it's not impressive at all. But you hold it up to the light, and preferably outside in the sunlight, and it comes to life. The detail on that that's in the photo is amazing. I found the STL file for the Mona Lisa on Thingiverse, and a link for that will be in the description for this video. I had a photo dating back to the early 1930s of my mother. It was a sepia, darkened with age, and I worked on the scanned image to brighten it, and then used that in Cura to create a lithophane, and it turned out really nice. I'd like to show you how I made that. One thing about Cura that people may not know about is the ability to import a photograph to create a lithophane. We're going to bring in a file. This works best with black and white photographs. So if you have a color photograph, it'd be best to convert that to black and white and something that's bright without too much contrast. This box comes up and you have to select the correct information here. The length of it, I'm going to create 125. Light is higher or dark is higher. We want dark to be higher. We want the thinnest part of the lithopane to be the brightest part so light can go through that. And areas that are darker, like the hair or clothing, we want it to be thicker so the light has a little more trouble getting through it and it will appear darker. We're going to make that 2.5. I'm going to make this 0.2 to begin with. I already know that this is too thin, but this is a demonstration. And it puts it flat on the build plate, which we really can't use. These turn out much better if you print them on edge. So I'm going to rotate this. And I turn it until it says 90 degrees. Over here, my layer height will be 0.12 millimeter. I have found that works very well for this. It's 100% infill density. And I'm going to print it on a two-layer raft. Tell it to prepare. I have sliced it. Up here I'm going to go to layer view. When I look at the back side of this print, it has all these holes in it. That means that I have chosen for the plastic to be too thin. Unfortunately, I have not found a way to correct this. So we just clear the build plate. We go back and we import that photo again. And I'm going to change this to 0.5 base thickness. So the thinnest part of the lithopane will be half a millimeter thick. And the thickest portion will be 2.5 millimeters. Okay, we're going to stand that on edge again. And I'm printing this on its side. Slice it. And layer view. And when I look at the back of this, there are no holes. So this should be a good print. And I like to look at the top of these prints. I do this on almost anything that I create in Cura. Look at layer view, and I can come down through this thing and look at it layer by layer as it's being printed. And right here is one of the thinnest areas. This will be in the face. And I like to go through this and just double check to make sure there's not anything unusual. This is real thin, but still there's no hole. And I look at that from the very bottom. This is when it first starts to lay down the raft, all the way up to the top. Make sure there's no surprises. Again, this would be laying on its side. It just means that when it gets to the final part of the print, it's not sticking up here any higher than it has to be. This is quite small. And it's always possible that something will go wrong. You'll get a glob on your nozzle, or the printhead will come by and maybe crack this thing off of the build plate. And that's why we're using a raft, so that doesn't happen. The other part of this is I print this lying down in the Y direction. There's a lot less shaking involved. The Y direction is going straight back and forth. All the movement is up here in the printhead. This print will take 6 hours and 15 minutes. The Mona Lisa took 8.5 hours.